In this question, we have to find the value of square root of 27 using differentials. Okay, we are not going to use any calculator or any other thing for finding the values. Now, let's start it. First step is, as I told you, first step is just write it under root 27. Just write what is the nearest value for a number whose square is in the whole numbers. Okay, for example, here we are having 25 plus 2. We are knowing that 25 is 5 square. Now this thing you have to judge it. Okay, now let y is equal to under root x. Okay, let's start it now. Let y is equal to under root x. Now these things also we are going to use it. Now here, by using the first principle, what you did in class 11th. Now let's write it. Let delta x be a non-zero. Delta x be a non-zero increment of x. Non-zero increment of x and delta y, the corresponding increment of y. Now, adding delta y and delta x to the y and x respectively, we are having y plus delta y is equal to x plus delta x. Now we are adding delta y and delta x, the small increments, delta y in y and delta x in x. Okay, so if x is in the square root, you have to add delta x here, not outside of the square root of x. Okay, so now suppose this is equation 1, this is equation 2. Now subtracting 1 from 2. Now what we are getting? Delta y is equal to square root of x plus delta x minus square root of x. Okay. Now to delta y, what we can write it? Dy by dx with delta x is equal to square root for x plus delta x minus square root of x. Now from where we get this thing? Now we can write it dy is equal to dy by dx with delta x and be the approximate be the approximation equals to delta y, or we can write it dy is equal to dy by dx into delta x be the approximate equal to delta y, or is, we can write it is approximate in place of be the, you can write it is approximate equal to delta y. Now what it was, let me tell you once again what we have done it in class 11th. Limit if delta x approaches to 0, delta y by delta x, we know it becomes dy by dx. Okay, so using this concept in mind, we got this thing. Now for dy by dx, what to do for dy by dx? Now what our question was? Our question was y is equal to, now y is equal to square root of x, or we can write it y is equal to 1 upon x raised to power 1 upon 2. Now differentiating with respect to x, we are getting dy by dx is equal to 1 upon 2 under root x. Now in place of dy by dx, I am going to put this term. In place of this dy by dx, we are putting that one. 1 upon 2 under root x with, now with delta x is equal to x plus delta x minus under root x. Now this becomes square root of x plus delta x is equal to 1 upon 2 root x delta x plus under root x. Now what are the values for x and delta x? Now let's compare this one from here. Now comparing this with x plus delta x, what we are getting? We are getting this is equal to 25 plus 2, or we can write it x is equal to 25 and delta x is equal to 2. Okay, so these values we are getting from the question, which we assumed that nearest value, nearest square root for 27 is 25. So now we are going to put these values in our question. Now x plus delta x is our question itself, 25 plus 2. So we can write it 25 plus 2 is equal to 1 upon 2 square root of 25 with delta x is 2 plus square root of 25. Now you just have to fill the values. Now square root of 27 is equal to 1 upon 10 into 2. 1 upon 2 into 5, we are having 1 upon 2 into 5 into 5. Sorry, into 2 plus 5. So here this cancels. Now 1 upon 5 means what? 0.2 plus 5, and this is equal to 5.02. This is answer. Okay, no depth of the calculations, just simple, with simple calculations we have got how to solve the question for square root of 27.